Alone in the vastness of the ocean, flowing together with the transparency of sky. Nothing to hide, freedom and height, being oneself. The waters changed to blue and green. Soon we will reach the coast, another page in the discovery of truth. The waves of grass are so similar, like the oceans, so humble, modest, open to the divine. Tiny bays of self, a voyager upon eternity's seas, lost in the scattering stars. A seeker of the islands of the blessed, he leaves the last lands, crosses the ultimate seas. He turns to eternal things, his symbol quest. He sails through life and death and other life. He travels on through waking and through sleep. A power is on him from her occult force that ties him to his own creation's fate. And never can the mighty traveler rest, and never can the mystic voyage cease, till the nescient dusk is lifted from man's soul, and the morns of God have overtaken his night. As long as nature lasts, he too is there. For this is sure, that he and she are one. There is a truth to know, a work to do. Her play is real, a mystery he fulfills. There is a plan in the mother's deep world whim, a purpose in her vast and random game. The adoration of the Divine Mother is in my heart. My only will is to aspire for her presence and to serve. Her guidance is to find her secret powers that can lead the world. Where is that bridge between her sincerity and the grace of humility? Sincerity is the first key to belong to the divine, to live only for the divine, to will only what the divine wills, to express only the divine will, to have no other source of energy than that of the divine. How to become that? How to aspire for sincerity? How to prepare and concentrate on that idea, more and more diving into the depth of our true being. How to become aware of one's own resistance in thought, feeling, and body, and to offer it to the divine in us. To pray for a sincere flame to be kindled on every level of our being. We have traveled so many roads, but we are still there at the beginning of our journey. O Mother, only you, please send me your force to proceed further, to hold on and follow the sunlit path. Oh, please bring your light, your conscious power to us that will free us from all narrowness of ego and pride, that we will be able to open ourselves to your grace and constant guidance. Please kindle the light of humility in our hearts.
We must learn that whatever our efforts, whatever our struggles, whatever even our victories compared with the path still to be traversed, is nothing. Do not think yourself big or small, very important or very unimportant, for we are nothing in ourselves. We must only live to become what the divine wills of us. True humility consists in knowing that the supreme consciousness, the supreme will alone exists, and the I is not. The more we advance on the path, the more modest we become, and the more we see that we have done nothing in comparison to what remains to be done. To be humble means for the mind, the vital, and the body never to forget that without the divine, they know nothing, are nothing, and can do nothing. Without the divine, they are nothing but ignorance, chaos, and impotence. The divine alone is truth, life, power, love, felicity. Therefore, the mind, the vital, and the body must learn and feel once and for all that they are wholly incapable of understanding and judging the divine, not only in his essence, but also in his action and manifestation. This is the only true humility, and with it come quiet and peace.